Phony PPL is a five-person R&B group out of Brooklyn. That is, it's usually a five-person group. On this day, though, there's a sixth member. His name, or rather, its name, is Watson. Yep, that Watson. The supercomputer from IBM that does everything from play Jeopardy to cook food to help cure cancer.
My initial reaction was like, whoa.
Phony PPL plays 10 seconds of music that Watson beat, which is what this version of Watson is called, listens to, analyzes, and then using artificial intelligence creates a track in one of six different moods.
I get the beginning of what it's actually doing, but then there's a point of it where it's way beyond my comprehension. But I understand like flow charts. So this is what we're putting into it, and this is what's coming out of it. And then there's an algorithm processing it to turn it into what the result is. So it's pretty cool like how minute or how minimal your idea could be that you input into Watson. And then what comes back out is like, yo, are you serious? Especially the first time you used it, it's just like mind blowing.
Unlike some streaming services like Spotify, which recommends song based on what you like, Watson Beat makes music based on what you like. Now let's see how it works.
At the heart of Watson Beat, there are a lot of machine learning algorithms and artificial algorithms involved in this. It understands music theory and emotions and how music and emotions connect and correlate with each other. So what it does is you play a piece of music and it's listening to it, and since it understands music theory and it can connect with emotions and moods, it takes that piece and learns that beat. It gets inspired by that piece that you play and adds on top of it layers of emotion.
Good fun, yeah, but is it practical? Would musicians actually use Watson Beat to make music more than just goofing around?
Every artist, musician ever will tell you that writer's block is real, and there are days in which you feel like, all right, today I'm just going to knock out as many songs as I can, and you get stuck on the first idea. So I think Watson is a good kind of, it's a good platform for when you're in that rut. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know what to write, and just play a couple notes, and it'll give you some kind of an inspiration. Go a whole other way than you might have thought originally.
Right. Yeah. It's not like it's gonna make a song for you or make this shit great if it wasn't great in the first place, but it could definitely give you more seasoning. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Things that you can use to incorporate, like, okay, this one idea, I wouldn't have it going through a song for 3 minutes straight, but this is a new idea that I didn't have originally that we can incorporate in here sometime. And that's the way I would use Watson. Like, you know?
In fact, Phony PPL got so inspired by the music Watson Beat was making, they started working on a song, even writing lyrics on the spot.
Watson Beat seemed like a dream for musicians, and by the end of the year, you can use it too, because IBM says an app is coming out, so be prepared for that.
We want to be able to analyze audio instead of just MIDI data, so that you could sing into it, you can play a guitar into it, and then it could create whole compositions from audio files as well.
Whoa, at some point you'll be able to speak into a machine and a song will come out? Now that's the future. I'm Keith Nelson Jr. from Digital Trends, and this has been Watson Beat.life.